Right, here we are in a car park in Lelystad. This is called the Agora Deck. And well, I just parked here. Let's see if there's any good lifts here. But first, I have to get a parking ticket. Let's see. Uurtarief, dagtarief. This display is very touchy. If you can easily touch, it's not very responsive. Right, let's see if this works. This thing is strange and not very user friendly. It says maximale parkeerduur bereikt. That is very strange. It's not very. Einde parkeertijd, 11:45. But actually, this is the current time. I don't really get. How does this bloody thing work? Normally, you enter the amount of time you want. 11:45, that is nu. What is it for vaag ding? Well, I managed to resolve it, but the device is not very user friendly, but I managed to get a thing out of the machine. So but yeah, this car park is rather old, as you can see, and it has rather narrow parking spaces. But yeah, that machine over there, I managed to crash it. I think it's still, yeah, it's still in a non-working state. So also be careful when you open your door here. This is less than ideal. So well, let's see if there are any lifts in this car park. But yeah, that machine was a bit strange. It's not very user friendly, and if you type in your license plate number, it often repeats the number that you entered. So it doesn't have the best touchscreen. And as you can see, this is actually, well, just a flat plate construction here with mushroom columns. That's actually not too bad, but yeah, they really need to sort out that parking machine. It's not great. So let's explore this car park for a bit. It doesn't look like there's any lift here. Oh, hey, that ends up in an area with apartments. And this column here is a bit different. Oh, this is actually not a column, but some kind of tube. Well, actually, this parking deck is rather straightforward. Let's see what we got here. Another stairway that I think will probably lead to apartments. This is sort of Streets in the Sky like concept here. Interesting. Let's see if this goes anywhere. Nope. I wonder how that scooter got here if there's no lift. There's clearly no lift in this area. So let's check out that hotel over there. This is the bicycle ramp. Yeah, this looks rather interesting. We've got apartments on top of a parking deck with a really stubborn ticket machine, I have to say that. They really need to sort that thing out. Oh, there's a Chinese restaurant on top. And there's some kind of hotel with some rather interesting concrete facades. I must say this looks rather interesting. This architecture here is a bit weird and a bit different. Alright, now we are in a hotel and these lifts, they look rather interesting. Let's see, although they are modernized. I don't know what the brand is, but it looks like a modernized lift. It doesn't move because you probably need... Yeah. The floors are locked off, unfortunately. But yeah, the cap is quite interesting. Hey, did it actually move? Sadly, there is some copyrighted music playing. But yeah, I wonder what these lifts originally would have been. They are clearly modernized. But something about these is still original. Oh, actually, this is an old Mitsubishi. But it's not modernized by Mitsubishi.
Yes, you're welcome.
Even though it has some very nice old arrows. Oh yes, it's 12 o'clock on Monday. They're testing the alarm. In the Netherlands, they always test the alarm at the first Monday of the month at exactly 12 o'clock. That's some of, that is the old air raid thing. I believe it dates back from the Cold War period. Well, let's check out this area over here. This looks a bit dark. I must say there's not a lot of people about here. So the alarm test is over now. But yeah, that was a really old-fashioned air raid alarm. And they test that every, well, first Monday of the month at exactly 12 o'clock. Right, let's check this area over here. Well, there isn't really much to see here. This is completely locked off. Still, the architecture of this place is kind of interesting. There's some other walkway up there. I wonder what that could be. Let's check that out. Let's see, what is this? This is some other streets in the sky kind of thing. Oh, it leads to a fence. Interesting, but Yeah, you end up here at a fence. And there's some more housing over there, but this here is the city hall. It was built in the 1980s, like pretty much everything here. This entire place looks like it was built in the 1980s. As you can see, everything looks like it's pretty run down here. It's, well, it has a weird kind of atmosphere to it. Everything looks so run down, even though it's not very old. Actually, this is rather interesting. Here are some precast concrete facades. And one of the biggest precast concrete factories of the Netherlands is actually located in Lelystad. But I doubt they made these ones. But yeah, Lelystad is not a very old place. It was first built in the 1960s, so the oldest buildings are about 50 years old. And a lot of this stuff is from the 1980s. Alright, well, there's the railway station. But as you can see, this area looks very run down. It looks like it was quite something in the 1980s, but right now it has kind of lost its shine. But hey, that building looks a bit interesting. I wonder if I can get into it. But here's something that they're demolishing, or has been demolished. Yeah, actually, I'm starting to get hungry. I might eat something at the railway station, perhaps. You can even still see the hollow core floors there. They demolished something of this building. But yeah, everything has such a rundown atmosphere to it. This is really weird. It's not even that old, but so run down. Alright, I'm back in the car park. I'm going home. But yeah, the machine seems to have reset itself. So yeah, it was a little bit weird. But well, my conclusion of Lelystad is that it's a pretty run-down place. So yeah, it's well, it does have a nice old star lift. But yeah, this is the end of the video. I hope you enjoyed it and thanks for watching. Very nice old fixtures, and it even has a fan which we can turn off. Nice.